But you know what, what also God will make me do?
Pray
more. Y'all come Wednesday night because it talks about praying for those officials. Let me tell y'all something, don't y'all, because y'all spiritual, don't you get in the mindset, I ain't praying for him.
That's right.
No, the Bible says pray for those who are the Lord.
That's right.
Am I in your Bible?
Yes.
I'm going to tell you what it's at. But I'll tell you, come back Wednesday, I'm going to tell you more about it. It's in 1 Timothy. Chapter 2. That's all I'm telling you. So don't worry about him. Keep your focus. Keep your focus.
That's it.
My soul longs, yes, even. Watch this. If you got your Bible, still open your devices, still available. Turn to Psalms 84. And 2. Psalms 84 and 2. And I'm waiting for you. You got one more to go after this one. You will see what God says. I still hear page here. I'm waiting. You there?
Yeah.
All right. My soul longs. My soul craves.
Yes.
Watch this. Even faints in the courts of the Lord. I got to stop there for a moment. Notice what the text says. My soul longs. Yes. Which, given confirmation, his soul is hungry. Even faints for the courts of the Lord. Now, y'all know what he's talking about here?
Yeah.
His courts is the house of God.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Satan.
We should, when I was in high school, we used to ask people, what church you go to? They would say, Stay Home Baptist. Y'all come back this morning,
amen.
Stay Home Baptist. Look at this, look at what the psalmist says. The psalmist says, my soul longs, yes, even faints for the house of God. Why does he hunger and he longs? His soul is in a man. Because there's something about God's house that brings about strength.
Yes.
There's something about God's house that brings about deliverance and freedom.
Yes.
That's why he said, I'm hungry if I can get to the house. I go back to the old days. I remember when we were growing up as a boy, and all saying, I cannot wait till I get to the house. I can't wait till I get to God's house. Because I believe you'll get there. Something gonna happen when I get to God's house. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 10, says, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together.
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of Acts, I will inherit from among them that are sanctified.
Amen.
Stay Home Baptist is not sanctified.
Amen.
Oh, Holy Ghost, thank you. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I got to put a foot in the quick note here. That's why it's important that we be sanctified, because we can defile the house of God.
Amen. Amen.
We can defile the house of God how we come in the house of God.
That's right.
We can defile the house of God how we feel, our demeanor, our attitude. We can defile the house of God. Mm-hmm. So he longs to be in the house. He can't wait to get in the house. Hello, sis. He ain't walking, y'all. He
walking.
Because watch this, he's enthusiastic about being in the house where God is. Ooh, Jesus. Watch this. He says, my heart and my flesh cry out for the living God.
Yes.
And when I get in the house, I'm lifting my voice to the living God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Guess what happens? Goes into worship. He goes right into worship. Okay? I'm going to take you right into worship again. Turn your Bibles or hit on your device. Psalms 143 and 6. Psalms 143 and 6. The devil fights what he fights, and the devil fights his tooth and nail. Because brothers and sisters, he knows that there is victory in the house. You got it? All right. I spread, I'm going to read the King James. I spread out my hands to you. That's worship. That's worship. He's describing what he's doing. I'm spreading out my hands to you. My soul longs for you like a thirsty lamb. I got my hands spread. God, I got to help you. My inner man, my spirit man longs for you. I got to help you, God. I need you, God. As I said earlier, I'm going through, God, and I need you. I need you to move for me. I need you to move in a mighty way for me, in an awesome way for me. God, I come before you to worship you. I'm hungry for you. I'm craving you. I'm desiring you. Hungry and thirsting after you. Ain't no ifs and ands about it. I got to help you. I got to help you. I got you. So I'm coming to your house. I told you. My soul longs, yes, even faints. But I'm longing for the house of your courts. I'm longing to be where you are in the house. Yeah, somebody gonna say if they don't say, they gonna think. Well, I can do this at home. Not in its totality. No. The Bible says again, going back to Acts. He says, our inheritance is among them that are sanctified. Okay. It means we draw strength from each other. And that's why, oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. That's why the devil fights us tooth and nail, but we don't try to just not get along, because he knows that our strength is from each other. Amen. We draw strength. We draw encouragement from one another. Yes. Yes. And he don't want us to do that. Yeah. And that's why I stay on Baptist, ain't gonna help you. Oh, well, it's Pentecost, church. Stay around Pentecost. You see, I'm talking about the real. I'm for real. Because it's about holy business. Too many things are happening. Just all of a sudden, got a phone call, Brother Darrell couldn't walk in the emergency room. They're doing tests on him now, why he can't walk, why he's in so much pain. And it's time for the church and us to come together as one, not divided, but as one. I promise you, because according to scripture, when we look at the people who came together as one mind, one spirit, one God starts to move, starts to reveal, God starts to manifest, God starts to deliver, God starts to heal, because the people came together with one mind, one call, and to see Jesus.
Yes.
To see him.
Wow.
And I said last week, the devil really, I should have said it, maybe. Right, sorry, I'm saying it again too. That's why I want to see the people of God be blessed, healed, strengthened, and delivered. But he's bothering me because he knows it's a burden to me. Because he knows I have the love for the saints. And so when he sees that, he tries to mess with me. But you know what? Just catch me now. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Jesus had a love for the people too. He said, I've given you the same love that Jesus had. He said, but watch what Jesus did. He kept praying for them.
Yes, he did.
And if you look at it, Jesus didn't really let them be alone with him. He prayed for them because he knew that, watch it, he knew that they were going to be delivered. I showed you last week about this 8. This is 10. Jesus didn't literally go to his house. Listen. But the centurion father said, speak a word.
Right.
And my son shall be healed. He didn't say might be healed. He said, my son shall be healed.
Yes.
And when he got to the house, the Bible says, he was healed.
Yes.
And I believe the book. Same thing will happen in the 21st century time.
Yes, sir.
I believe it.
Yes.
I believe it. We have just seen, and I'm closing, we have just seen people in this house where God is blessed.
Amen. All right. All right. Amen.
And God is not through. He's showing us through these persons that you be encouraged who haven't got yours yet.
All right.
Can I say it again?
Yes.
You, he showed it to you. There's you who haven't got yours yet. Won't you be weary? Hear me, church. Don't you be weary. Shirley says you're next in line. You're next in line. You keep holding faith. You keep trusting God. You keep believing God. Because you're next in line. The Lord bless you. He's done. I'm done. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. Longing for you. We'll come next week. Again in Psalms. There's so much wealth of worship and praise in Psalms. I'm coming from Psalm 62 and 1 next week. And maybe verse 2. I do know the Lord to show me verse 1 of Psalm 63. We see what he says, we go to verse 2 next week. But be encouraged, be strengthened in the Lord, because God has got you in mind. It just came back to me. 7 years ago, from Jeremiah 29:11, was somebody preaching, and the subject was, God got you on his mind. I want to say it from Jeremiah 29:11, God's got you on his mind. If you don't know it, go read it. He's got you on his mind. And it's good to be on his mind. Amen. As a choir of saints, there may be someone that desires prayer. If there's such persons, will you come? Maybe somebody in the house is not saved, don't know the Lord as your personal Savior. He is here to save you. He's here to make you a new person. He's here. As we stand all over the church, whatever you need from the Lord, will you come? Whatever you need.